asked Bernie Sanders. Flaker says many of the manufacturing jobs that remain are harder to get because they require a lot more training.
If you compare life back in the 40s, in the 50s, where you could even drop out of high school, walk down the road and get a job at the GM plant.
Hey, buddy, I gotta go. I'll be right back.
That kind of job just doesn't
I'll be right back, okay?
Anymore.
The job losses have to make easy.
No. I'll be right back. Hasta luego.
Small, heavily Republican city south of Indianapolis, dominated by Cummins, the Fortune 500 company that sells diesel engines around the world. But it isn't hard to find people who see trade as a bad word. Matt Coy has been watching Trump on TV, and at 47, he's decided to vote for the first time.
I got three factory jobs in the last 10 years to go to China or to go to Mexico or to go somewhere out of the country. We're losing our jobs to everybody else. We need a
plan.
I think you can do it.
President Biden, the secretary, is voting for Trump, too.
There's too many jobs and manufacturers that went out of our country, and there's too much coming in. I mean, this is a free country. Anybody can come in it. But we have had an excess that puts our people out of work.
Those aren't necessarily the majority of pains. Russell Poling is an engineer at Cummins. He says the U.S. has to be able to compete globally. And he's skeptical about talk of tariffs and trade wars.
We're trying to export. We can't cut off imports. Because that's what some people would like to see. We don't import anything, but we ship everything out. We can't do that. Because nobody will take it.
But even Poland says trade has to be balanced, and he's not sure it is these days. Indiana may have companies that compete globally, but in places like Columbus, there's an uneasy sense that too many people have been left behind. And that's likely to sway some votes in tomorrow's primary. Jim Zaroli, NPR News.
Elephants at the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus took their final bow last night. They head for retirement today. It's the end of the circus's battle with animal rights groups, and one that has stretched on for decades. NPR's Arun Roth went to Providence, Rhode Island last night to catch the elephants.
I hadn't been to the circus in 1970, but it's a fucking bright laugh, as I remember. Life that performance may have been a farewell, but the circus doesn't do that.
Rocky Reynolds and his 8-year-old son, Alan, were sad to say goodbye.
Oh, let's see how that was.